And we're back. Alright, I upped the brightness on my TV a bit. Doesn't really look like it helped too much on the PVR, but I can see the corners of the room now clearly. Which will be useful, I suppose, for not missing those herbs. I really don't like the fact that I had to do that, though. See, most games will... Where's my fucking grenade launcher? Thank you. Most games will let you adjust the brightness of the game, but this one doesn't, so you have to fuck with your TV, and I hate having to fuck with my TV. Do I have everything I need here? Yes. Why am I carrying the grenade launcher? Probably because I don't have any tolerance for bandersnatches. I just don't fucking want them there. They suck, I hate them, I want them out of the... This bastard, I'm just never going to kill. I have to run by him one more time, but... He's not the one that concerns me. Now, there should be a whole mob of zombies up here, like Walking Dead style. Oh, yes. Hey there! I need my camera. Down you go, bitch. This is why the auto is awesome. Two trigger pulls. I got one more pull left. Reload, Claire. Did I hit nothing with that shot? It looks like it. Why are you not dead yet? Went through a lot of bullets, but I don't care. Just have plenty of them. Grenade launcher. Ideally, you want to save this for, like, Tyrant and Hunters later on, but... It's okay to use it on Bandersnatches in a couple of instances. Where is he? Oh, there he is. Bye. Fuck you! Oh, now you die. One shot. Sometimes we'll kill him. It's 1-2. I'm still fine, which is good, but that's not gonna last, because there's zombies right in here, and I think they might get a cheap grab. Shouldn't have to deal with them ever again. Let's try and avoid a cheap grab, Claire. That would be ideal. Two auto shots, put him down. Two auto shots, put him down. Finish him, please. I believe there's one that's coming down the stairs. I know he spawns right by him. Actually, let's have a look. What's great is you can use this angle here to see up there. It's clear. So the zombie's not right by the stairs yet. If I continue jerking off around the staircase here, though, he might be by the time I get up here. I'm gonna move slow here because I want to make sure of the zombie's location. Yeah, he's close. Fuck you. And he's dead too, that's awesome. He's coming down the stairs. Let's go to the bowgun. I can hit him from here, awesome. And he's dead, sweet. Okay, great. Nah, that's not everything. There should be zombies in here, too. That's why we have a lot of handgun ammo, and why I'm not afraid to, like, just unload with it. We don't really need the handgun much, aside from to clear these areas out. Excuse me. Still another zombie back there. Of course there is. Why would there not be? Oh, fast mover too. Fuck you. Through the door, Claire. You see how he kind of slid around the corner there? Yeah, not playing that game. We'll just let you re-roll a slow-moving, shuffling idiot zombie. shuffling idiot. And I'll just use a single bullet there to finish him off, which I guess is kind of lucky that that happened that way. Single bullet. Why are you not dead yet, Bob? Oh, fuck. Yeah, that was my fault. Deserve it. Totally deserve it. Yeah, and I'm in caution because I'm a fucking idiot. Crash down, you idiot. Duh. Okay, everybody laugh at Crash Down now. Haha, you dumbass. You're so stupid. Cutscene here, I believe. Or is it after I do all this stupid shit? It's after. Because, yeah, I can't go through that yet, which would be convenient. Dumbass. Come here, you zombie fuckers. Go down, goddammit. Okay, finally. Shouldn't take 3 trigger pulls to put them down, but sometimes it does. There. That's what we needed to come up here to do. Why do I have this nub spray on me? What the fuck was I thinking? Thought I had a green herb in my inventory. I'm stupid. I'm not using the nub spray. Fuck that. Okay, let's go up here. Yay, we can go up here now. Get the last proof. We'll come down. Yeah. I don't remember if there's like any other pickups. I know the key that I need is right here. Somewhere. Yeah, it's a dragonfly. I can't remember if there's like bullets or something in the background. All this shit I think you can check. Well, maybe not. Okay. Nothing useful. Yeah, exactly. Story of my life, Claire. I just take the wings off. As they showed us in the cutscene that gets flagged for copyright. Yeah, lovely. I'll just use that. Yay! The ladder's lined up now. Oh, look at that! I would not have seen that had I not turned my brightness up. There we go. There's my caution remedy right there. Bam. We're good. Okay. I didn't see it the first time I ran by, though, but I wasn't really looking at the ground. I was kind of looking for ammo sitting, or other pickups sitting up on, like, shelves and shit. Which, we have a file here. A 10-year-old girl genius graduated at the top of her class from a prestigious university. The International Corporation Umbrella Chemical offered her the position of head researcher. Yeah, they're talking about Alexia here. Hidden ammo. Well, it's not really hidden. Yeah, it kinda is. You don't really see it. Ink ribbon I don't give a shit about. Typewriter I don't give a shit about. But what I do give a shit about is what's up here, underneath this book. Confession. Alexia, my sister, is a genius and possesses unmatched beauty. She is everything to me. I would overcome any obstacle and be willing to risk my life for her. For Alexia, I must revive the glorious Ashford family, which fell during the era of my father, Alexander. Together, we will restore our family name. Once that has been achieved, I'll build a palace where only nobles may gather. I cannot allow the unwashed to see my dear Alexia, to whom my life is devoted to. She reigns the world as queen and I as her servant. That is my dream, and how sweet it will be. Those accomplishments will be the proof of my love towards Alexia. It is the purpose of my existence. All other people are meaningless, and they shall soon prostrate themselves before Alexia and I. Devoted to my beloved Alexia, Al, yep, the crazy guy, got it. Okay, moving on. Give me the Air Force proof, thank you, that's what I was up here for. Let's get the hell out of here, Claire. Now I think when we go back down, I don't remember which room we come down into. I know the blue one is Alfred's, the red's Alexios. I can't remember which one, but there's a cutscene when we come down. And this one's kind of amusing. Or did we already have that scene? No, we couldn't. We hadn't had that scene yet. Yeah, it's right here.
Claire
right here.
Redfield. Hold it right there.
We meet each other at last. A pity I must say goodbye so soon. I am Alexia Ashford, for the pride of the Ashford
family. Are you sure about that?
I will kill you. Wait!
What's going on?
Yeah, okay, you were out of ammo, but whatever.
Steve!
Sure, that happened.
After her.
You sure about that?
Are you okay?
Steve just got shot in the arm with at least a .22 caliber rifle.
I'm
he
fine.
Gets up just fine.
It's just a scratch.
Just a scratch. Yeah, about the only reasonable explanation there is maybe he had the wind knocked out of him from the actual bullet just missing his arm. Oh, look, a wig and blood.
This must be.
Yep, Al's not exactly right in the head.
What? No!
You totally don't need to shoot him, Steve.
Wait
his
a
multiple
second.
Personality
what
disorder
just
kind of took hold of
so
him there.
So there never was an Alexia after all.
You mean?
Oh, I wouldn't say
he
that.
He thinks he's two people? Okay, that's it. Let's get out of here.
The self-destruct system has...
Oh, you bastard. That's not
nice.
He's
trying to blow us up along with the entire facility. Come on, we gotta get to that airport.
Right.
Yeah, we gotta get out of here. I should have a clean run all the way out, like all the way, except for that Bandersnatch in the office that I chose to not kill. Unless the game decided to respawn enemies to aggravate me. But I don't see that being the case. A lot of times, though, they will respawn enemies after cutscenes, or key events take place. But I think we're pretty safe here. I don't know. Let's see if these assholes respawn. Yeah, I skipped that room over there entirely. I just don't care. I'm pretty sure there's nothing in there except some bowgun rounds anyway. There's nothing in there that's required to complete the game, as I am about to prove. But there's two Bandersnatches in that room, so it's not even fucking worth it. Because you have to fight them in close quarters. Which, yeah, I mean, you can just run up to him and blast him with the grenade launcher, but still, it just seems wasteful. Grenades for bowgun rounds, not even worth it. Now, explosive arrows, that's a different story. Two grenades for some explosive arrows? Oh, fuck yes, please, give them to me every time. Fuck you. Prepare to die in an explosion, ass bandit. Let's get what we need here, Claire. Don't need the grenade launcher right now. I don't think. I will need it shortly. But I need this. Where the hell's the other proof? Fuck you, first aid spray. I don't want you. Should load my gun, too. Just in case... Be curious when I get to the Arctic, because I don't know how well I remember that area. Probably be waffling a little bit, but it's not nearly as large as this area, so if I do fuck up, it's like, oh, okay, I only have to go back like three rooms at the most. Where Whereas here, you Claire. Can totally go really far out of your way.
Those must be the remaining survivors.
We'd better get out of here, too.
Right. Let's go.
Well, no shit.
The self-destruct system
has... Oh, good. Self-destruct has been activated. Lovely. Now, I'll be honest with you guys.
We gotta get to that airport.
When Steve stops babbling. Come on, Steve, turn the wheel. The first time I played this game, I thought this was the ending. Like, yeah, okay, let's get the fuck out of here. Yeah, game's over. Oh, we're not even half done. That totally threw me off on my first playthrough. Like, holy shit, we're still going. Well, I had the GameCube version, so I wasn't too surprised by it because it has two discs. And once you get to Antarctica, it says change to disc 2. But at first I was thinking the second disc was like the extra games and shit like that. I didn't even think that it was like the second half of the story. Which being that I'm playing this on PSN, we won't have to change discs. Not getting out of here quite yet. We got a couple things to do. Shoot this asshole. Whoops. Why are you still standing, fucko? There's way too many bullets for one zombie. I'll take those, since I need to reload. Reload, Claire. Not a girl. Alright. That guy we don't need to deal with yet. I'll probably just run past him. I just want the two down because I gotta run back through here again. Let's bring the lift back. Yeah, I haven't come in here yet. No need to, really. Remember if there was anything in the corner. Let's go ahead and set these. Steve just kind of standing there like, yeah, all right, whatever. We have a box here, but we want to talk to Steve first.
No! We can't take off unless we raise the bridge!
Leave that to me. You stay here and make preparations for takeoff.
Yeah. I believe that cutscene is mandatory. I think in order to grab this too, I need to be up here. Which, this is the handle to control the bridge. It's conveniently on the plane. Why it's on the plane, who knows? They're just... Some wise ass thought it'd be funny to put it on there. Right, I probably have to unlock the door. Stairs, dumbass. That actually goes to the cargo hold, which we'll be going there in a few minutes. We'll be having fun there. Lots of fun. Okay, Bob, where are you at? Yeah, fuck you. Just not gonna mess with him. He can just wander around in his corner all day for all I care. Can't remember if there's enemies in here or not. Not is a good thing. I'll take that happily. We're gonna get the key to that right now. I think it's back here. I hope it's back here, or we might be in trouble. I think I have access to it once we move the bridge, which we're now about to do. Yes, raise the lever. Let's see, I can't get back that way now. So we have to find another way back to the plane, which requires us to literally go way the fuck out of it. Yeah, but they're down. I don't think they get up. Careful, Claire.
Self-destruct system has been activated.
Later, I think they will be alive, but there will be ammo in here. This is a puzzle that Chris needs to do later. So he'll have to come in here, kill zombies, and solve a puzzle. This place is going to blow up, which is, I've got to point this out, it's going to blow up, but it's not going to completely blow up. I mean, there's going to be explosions that are going to change some of the area, so when we come through later as Chris, it'll appear different. Yet, it'll still be intact enough that we'll be able to run around. It's kind of fucked up. It's like, I don't think they placed the charge as well. Because they didn't really destroy much of the facility at all, to be honest. You'll see what I mean when we get there. Okay, this is where we want to be. Now, we need to move these bad boys. I think we push this one in first. Then come back around here. A couple of greens, pretty. If I fuck this up, though, you know, the wall gnomes can assist me by resetting. You guys remember. I fucked it up. Looks like I can get there. I think I fucked it up. Yeah, I did. But I can do this, I think. Yeah, fuck it. Let's just reset it. I fucked it up. Second stack can throw you off when you're looking at it. What I mean by that is this stack right here, this tall one. I'm thinking, oh, yeah, that's what I need to do. So what I think I really need to do, first of all, I think I do this. I might be wrong about it, but I think this is what I do. Yeah. I know that. I need to clear this up. So. Ah, there we go. There we go. Now this should work. Yes. I don't know how I fucked it up last time, but that's what we needed to do. Now let's start picking shit up. Although, I think this will be here for Chris if I don't take it now, but I put most of it in the box anyway, so whatever I don't use, Chris will get. There's grenades here, which is really nice. I'm going to use a lot of these up anyway. I don't even care if I empty the grenade launcher with where I'm going, what I'm about to do. Okay, what I don't need is this. Well, I might actually keep it, but don't need a couple. I don't need some fucking random greens. Actually, I'm going to make a mixture, and I'll take this mixture also. Grenade launcher. I do have flame rounds.
Self-destruct system has been.
Might actually take those and use them.
Keep
this quick for now. Nah, fuck it. I won't need to shoot anything. You combine. You combine. I don't think this is going to be enough to do what I need to do, but I have the grenades to fall back on. We have to fight Tyrant up here. It's mandatory. You can't run past him either.
I will not allow you fools to escape. This is what you get for trying to oppose me. Now feel my revenge.
Seriously, Al, talking through with the woman's voice is kind of creepy. I get it, you're conflicted, but, you know, just saying. There's Tyrant. Yeah, he looks real happy, doesn't he? Like, come on, I was taking a nap. What the hell are you waking me up for? That's what Hunk's team was transporting, by the way, in the file we read. Alfred apparently wanted a Tyrant on the island for whatever fucking stupid reason. Probably just to annoy the hell out of Claire Redfield when she showed up. Right out here, as a matter of fact, the Tyrant says hello to me. Yeah, right here. Oh, shit! Explosion! That sucks. Oh no, I hate it when things just blow up at random. Well, hey dude! How you doing? Yeah, he does not look happy to see us, Claire. Well, let's start shooting him. Not yet. He has to go all the way down. Perfect. That's what we need. Used a lot of grenades, but oh well.
Your self-destruct system has been activated. All personnel.
La 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 la. How many grenades do I have left, by the way? That's kind of important, so I'm probably going to use all of them on them in the plane.
Your self-destruct system.
And it's okay to do that. Except the acid rounds, those stay in the fucking box for a very good reason. But I'll use up the BOW rounds, and the sub's back, even though in theory it shouldn't be. Unless someone came back with it. Like, what if Alfred came back with it or something? I don't know.
The self-destruct system has been activated.
Yes, let's climb down the ladder. The countdown timer is how much time you have to get to the plane. Which, that's a cakewalk.
The self-destruct system has been activated.
But it continues to tick during all and every load screen, too, so... But even still, it's more than fair. With the amount of time you have to get there. See, I can sit here and jerk off for a few seconds. It doesn't matter. I could actually probably go take a... Set my controller down, go take a piss, and come back. And still have plenty of time to make. I haven't actually tested that theory yet, but maybe if I end up live streaming this game, which I'll talk about. Hey Bob, you're gonna get blown up in an explosion. How does that make you feel? That zombie will be shown mercy due to an explosion. Yeah, look at this. We still got over 2 minutes left. Come on. Yeah, I had plenty of time to go take a piss if I wanted to. Hey Steve, you might want to take off now since this place is going to explode pretty quick.
What took you so long? I was starting to get worried.
No time to explain. Let's go.
Right.
Yeah, I had
to
shoot something.
Time to say goodbye to this death trap.
One death trap to another.
Over.
That's what you think. Yeah, first time playing this, I thought this was like
Claire,
the end of the game. I'm not even kidding.
I'm sorry. I know I caused a lot of trouble for you.
No, it's okay. It was hard for both of us.
Well, I really hope you find your brother. I know what it's like to be alone.
Oh, Steve.
So, where should we go now? I could take you anywhere you want to go, Claire.
I hear Hawaii's nice this time of year.
You got it.
Oh, Al looks pissed off. What's new, right? This dude's always upset about something. I don't know. Maybe what he had for breakfast isn't sitting well. Yeah. Oh, look at the secret area he reveals. At this point, I was like, oh, wait a minute. This game can't be over if there's ammo there and shit.
This game is not over yet.
Who's calling me?
Now you will see what real terror is all about.
Yeah, okay, you have a hairy rail friend, you know. Only the military can commission him. Granted, Umbrella has multi-billions of dollars and contacts with every country in the world. It just doesn't seem right that he has a hairy.
Hey! What the? The cargo room hatch is open.
I'll go back and check it out.
Yeah, I got this, Steve. You just fly the plane.
I've unlocked the cargo room door.
Right! Fun part. First real boss fight of the game. And that little instance with Tyrant before was just kind of a warm-up. This is the real thing right here. Alright, I need 10 of these. Actually, I need 20 of these. I need the gas rounds. And the handgun. Probably should take all my bullets, too, and just fucking use everything up and not care about it. Then, load this. Load these. We'll lead with these. He doesn't like these at all. I don't need the arrows. Standard recoveries aren't gonna cut it. I need red greens. Tyrant can kill you in like 2 to 3 hits. So you definitely need to make sure that you're okay in that sense. I probably have more than enough ammo. Another thing, I'm not going to save. I don't have to. This is a checkpoint. So if he kills me, which it could happen if I fuck up, I'll just restart right here. Yeah, I would be a little nervous about this one, too. Hey, big guy! Welcome aboard! Can I see your boarding pass, please, sir? He's thinking, I'll show you my boarding pass, bitch. Apparently I can't talk today. What the fuck's wrong with me? There's his boarding pass. Oh, it's ready? Awesome. Let's hit him with it right away. This does damage to him every time you hit him with it. Not even shitting you. Now we gotta run around and shoot him. He does not like those. That, sir, was not nice. I gotta move. Move, Claire. His second attack, which is an overhead chop, really fucking hurts. That can kill you in just a couple attacks. Let's go exploding arrows next. And he's actually knocking back. About out, aren't I? 3 left. And the grenade launcher. no, thank you. You'd kind of want to keep him at a mid-range, too, because he can dash at you. Oh, that was enough damage. Awesome. The exploding arrows do it. Seriously. Okay, let's go back through here. You have to do enough damage to him, then you can knock him out.
What was wrong?
Oh, nothing. Just a giant cockroach that had to be stepped on.
She's confident. The Fallen Tyrant.
What's happening?
I don't
here
know.
Here we have a fairly long cutscene.
Changed direction
so
on
I'm
its
gonna
own.
Go grab another beer.
It's flying in autopilot mode. I can't switch over to manual control.
My apologies, but I cannot let you escape now.
Alfred, you cross-dressing freak!
Hey, where are we?
Huh?
Latitude, 82.17 degrees. That's the Antarctic. We're over the Antarctic!
What?
Hey, those are the seaplanes that left the island right before us!
Then that must mean this place belongs to Umbrella.
Definitely not one of your better landings, Steve. And that's the end of the first half. Awesome, I have my beer. I probably should. I don't really have to, but yeah, I might as well just save the first half. I mean, it's the first half, so why not? Oh, wow, that doesn't actually count as a save. No, it doesn't. That's weird. Okay. Yeah, that's the first half of the game. Yay!
Oh. Hey, wake up, Steve.
Oh.
That's what happens when you don't wear your seatbelts, ladies and gentlemen. You end up laying somewhere in the cockpit.
Still alive.
With a headache. Whoops, I hope we don't need those stairs for anything. That would suck, because obviously, we can't get back into the plane either.
Thanks.
He's just like, I swear, Steve probably did have like a Beavis and Butthead moment.
Oh, plane's trashed. Well, let's split up and find another way off this oversized
No shit, Captain
freezer.
Obvious.
Right.
Exactly.
Okay. Let's do it.
You go back to doing whatever it is that you do, Steve, that does not contribute to us getting out of here whatsoever. that's pretty much it, too. Oh, I don't want to go through the double doors yet. None of these has a storage room. I think it's down the ladder. I'm not talking about the save room. I know where that is. It's down the stairs. Yeah, it's right here. Did I bring my handgun? Yeah, I did. Glad I brought that. There's supplies in here, quite a bit of them. Which we're probably gonna need, considering how we just went through a lot of stuff in the Tyrant boss fight. These zombies are inactive until I start picking shit up, I think. Don't know what actually causes them to rise, but see, here's a map I can't access until the zombie's out of the way. The zombie corpse is blocking me from getting this map. That's how you can tell they're alive, too. It's like, wait a minute, there's an object there that I cannot access. Now, what I can do is grab this, but, you know, I think this is what triggers them. The bowgun powder, yes. I don't really care if you get up. What triggers them? Is it the handgun ammo? And now I can't remember. I think there was something in one of the lockers. Yes, more ammo and a nub spray, which I don't really care about. I wanted the bullets, but okay, I guess I'll take that too since you forced me to. Yeah, I guess it's when you loot the locker and the zombies get up. You see there was bullets down there by his feet? Well, that's bullshit. You should be dead. That was way too many bullets for one zombie. I mean, I could take him out really fast with grenades, but that's just wasteful. I mean, this isn't exactly the best use to handgun ammo either, kill these things, but... Oh, bullshit. Get out of my way, fucker. Be dead now. Yeah, there's bullets here. But you see him in the cutscene when the zombie gets up. Otherwise, I don't think you can see him. I didn't want to check. Yeah, you really don't see him at any other corner of the room. Somewhere in here I thought there were grenade rounds. I might be wrong about that, but I thought there were. Yeah, I'll take the map. Fuck that! Don't need an ink ribbon taking up my only spot. If there's nothing else I need, fine, but I believe there's other shit I can take. More bullets, okay. I thought there were arrows in here too, but I guess I was wrong about that as well. There's a file here I want to read. Worker's Diary. October 30th, the day before Halloween, which would be next Friday. Today is Friday the 23rd. When I joined Umbrella Inc., I thought that I would be able to live carefree for the rest of my life, being employed by this huge corporation. It's a joke that I ended up being a driver at a place like this. I asked for a position change, but they completely ignored me. It feels more like a prison. Work is extremely demanding, and there's nothing fun about it. I'd rather be dead. Well, it looks like you got your wish, buddy. November 3rd. My hard-earned vacation was canceled suddenly. I heard they failed to secure enough manpower due to a mistake made by the facility head, Alfred. That fool doesn't deserve forgiveness. He doesn't even treat us like human beings. November 5th. I heard an interesting story from a guy who's been working here for over 8 years. He must be awfully patient. He says that there is a man who has been confined for over 10 years, locked up in a cell located deep below here. People call him Nosferatu and are deathly afraid of him. What an absurd story. November 10th. At midnight, I woke up to an ominous growling sound that seemed to be coming from deep underground. I'm so pathetic to have been frightened by such a foolish story. Then again, I suppose anyone would have a hard time maintaining their sanity if they were confined to a place like this. That's our first hint at Nosferatu's existence, although we'll find out soon enough more about him. I could have swore there were some grenade rounds in here. Maybe it's when you come back as Chris. Because, yeah, everything gets the items restocked in his playthrough, or his story. I guess I could take these, then. Yeah, that must be when we come back as Chris that we get that. Now we'll go down here to the save room. I really dread something, too. I wanted to point something out to you guys. Remember how I said the Bandersnatches were like one of the most annoying enemies in Resident Evil? They are, but there's an enemy that surpasses them, and they're right over there. The moths in this game, they suck more cock than, like, a 20-year veteran porn star. They are bad. I fucking hate them. I hate everything about them. Nothing really is more upsetting than being poisoned constantly. It's just, ugh, I hate them. Put me in a room with Nemesis and just a handgun and no recovery items any day, and I'll be less aggravated than I am by the moths in this game. Now that we got that out of the way, I'll start storing some shit. Like, for example, I don't need it. Why do I have so many first aid sprays? I don't need that shit. You here. You up here. Fucking nub sprays, go away. I don't like you, give me a green. So we're totally getting out of this annoying as shit caution mode. I need my arrows. Standard arrows, thank you. Good. We'll take these arrows. Fucking bolts, whatever, but they call them arrows, so be it. Take this herb. Take the herb, Claire. Guess I didn't need to pull one out. Can I move this back yet? Yeah. Oh, look at the little mouse. He's like, thanks. I appreciate that. You know, I didn't much like being stuck in that locker. Butler's letter. Sir Alfred, please forgive me, as I must tell you of my abrupt departure by leaving this letter. I first served your father, Lord Alexander, and have for so long shared in the joys and sorrows of the Ashford family. Lord Alexander disappeared unexpectedly 15 years ago. Then an accident during an experiment took the life of our dear Alexia. You were forced to become the master of the family at a very young age and nearly lost your sanity from the sorrow of having lost all your family members at once. Yeah, well, gee, him reading this is not going to bring back those horrible memories. Yeah, dumbass butler. Anyway, there was nothing I could do and I felt powerless. At first I thought I should kill myself to apologize. I then realized that it would be an insult to our dear Lord Alexander and Alexia in the other world. Scott Harmon Butler. Yep. We can't do that yet. Alright, they don't want us seeing those Nosferatu yet. First, we have to, what's the word I'm looking for here? Right, we need a halberd key for that. I think Chris gets that. You can go away. I shouldn't have to carry a recovery item with me. I'll find him. Gunpowder arrows go in here. Do I want to carry this guy? No. There we go. We'll just run around with these three items. Good enough. By the way, the moths won't activate until I go that direction. Claire's looking at them. But they won't attack you or anything until you actually go this way. And I'm going to have to do that sooner than later. I just prefer not to do it until I absolutely have to because I just hate them so goddamn much. They're good at dodging bullets, too. If I can get my hands on the AK before I fight them. that would be okay, but I don't think I can. I think the AK is actually down beyond them. Woo! We hear zombies. I'm looking for the power room. I think it's downstairs. Yeah, this is a machine room. This zombie here will never be able to get to us. Hey, how you doing? Are you hungry? See that case in there? We won't get to open that for a long fucking time. Like, a long, long, long... Ooh, look at that. There was ammo that's hidden by the environment. I'm not talking about that clip. I'm talking about this one. So you wouldn't even see this one without the help of this camera angle here. Blue herb, which I will take. Yeah. Probably need it. Diamond cutting edge. Oh yeah, this cuts anything and everything. Ink ribbon, I don't give two shits about. Okay. Hey, how you doing? Bet you'd like to take a bite out of this ass, wouldn't ya? Not happening, Bob. You just sit there in your own personal prison. I know, I'm such an asshole. I might actually have to go buy the moths now. I like the fact that I have a blue in my inventory. There is blue herb that grow next to him. It's like Capcom's way of apologizing for putting such an annoying enemy in the game. I think I have to go down there. I really don't want to. I would honestly rather, like, have a horrible shaving accident while shaving my ass. I'm not even kidding. Right, this is the hairier hangar right here. We can't go in there. So we do have to go by the moths. I'm so dreading this. This is gonna suck. I'm not even kidding. If I still had my flame rounds, those would actually work really well on them, but they were kind of put to good use against Tyrant. Oh, god damn, do I hate this thing. Time to squeeze the ass cheeks together and get it done. And fuck you, moth. Fuck you, moth. See how fast it is? It just gets you. You can't avoid it. It's so fucking annoying. I hate them. I'm poisoned and I have an egg on my back. So what we're going to do, wait till the egg's gone, because the egg will auto-poison you too, by the way. Just run in here, cure the poison, and run back out, and hope the fuck it doesn't get me while I'm doing it. God damn it! See why I hate these things? And they respawn too, so it's pointless to kill them. I'm not poisoned right now, but watch, once I throw this egg, which I'm still waiting for her to do, I think I have to leave the room, which is bullshit, because then I'll just get poisoned when I come back in again. Fine, let's do it. Because right now I'm just wasting bullets. I'm gonna kill this zombie first. I wish this fucking egg would disappear. Yeah, that auto-poisons you. It's fucking aggravating. So basically, I could play this whole area poisoned. I think I hit him. But see what I'm saying is the fuckers respawn every time you come through here. Which was a complete dick move by Capcom. Like, ha ha, we're gonna have them respawn every time! That'll make you happy. I'm in caution again and I don't care. I really don't down here. There's shotgun shells here, I think. We want to pick these up, too. Chris won't be able to get them. So what we want to do is pick those up and put them in the box so he has access to them later. Plus, you know, even if he did have access to the area, we'd still want to pick the lock so that he could get in there and get them. Now, as far as the zombie locations, these guys are kind of annoying where they tend to be. Can I go in the store yet? No. Fuck you. And he's still not dead. 9 bullets! That's okay. Let's make it an even 12. Are you dead now, Bob? I think there's one to the right also. Like back over here? No, I guess not. Yeah, I gotta... Where is the damn generator room? I'm trying to remember that. Yeah, let's combine your bullets with your bow gun. That's gonna work, stupid. I think it's right here. It better be. No, this is the bioorganic weapon room. There's spiders in here. They suck dick. Not as bad as the, I need something out of there, too. So I'm gonna go in here and take some hits now. The grenade launcher or the explosive arrows work really well here, and I have neither in my inventory, so this is going to hurt a lot. Here's spiders! Yeah! Grab up and munch me! Thank you very much. Nope! Stop that! Fucker. How badly hurt am I now? Orange. That's bad. Get me the fuck out of orange. I don't like orange at all. There's another spider in here. I thought there was. There's something I need out of the back of this room. It's not these stupid bolts either. What the hell is it that I need in here? Oh, there he is. Hi there, spider. I want the barcode sticker. I am not killing that one. Fuck it. The reason we need to get that... I probably should have showed it, but I didn't because of the first spider. Because the first spider is right by the door, that one spawns in the back of the room, so I should be able to show this okay. Gas mask. We'll need the gas mask. And we can't get it unless there's a gas leak. But we need the barcode sticker to cause a gas leak. It's all a chain reaction of crazy shit, and I'm honestly surprised that I remember how it works. Here's the weapons. There's the armory. Which, in here, is where I can get the AK. Thank the gods. Because the AK works really nicely on the annoying... Fuck you, zombie! Fuck you! It works really nicely on the, moths that annoy me so much. Here, Bob. Here, Bob. This, can I check... I don't think I can check this. Oh, I know what this is for. I think this is what I refuse to refuel the fire extinguisher. Which we won't do until we need to, and I can't see the zombie, which is kind of disturbing. He could be right up here on this... Right up here. Oh, he's not, but I will take the mining room key, because we need that. A lot of bullets. They give away a lot of free handgun ammo in this area. They're down. The AK should be right here. Fuck yes! There's the AK, ladies and gentlemen. It'll fill my inventory, but that's okay. This guy's got the detonator, which... need to pick that up. That'll work. Detonator goes here. Heat sensitive. Yeah, exactly. Thanks for that, Bob. Missiles are lined up here. I wonder what they plan to use them for. I don't know. We cannot do anything with that. If we still had, believe it or not, and as ridiculous as this sounds, if we still had the lighter, we could blow that door open. The lighter, completely unsafe. But, yeah. You know who's going to have a lighter later? Yeah, we know. Chris. Alright, let's go ahead and combine this. I need to come back out here. I think it's this box I used the barcode sticker on. Oh, there is a zombie that sits back there. Yeah, you're an asshole. Oh, you're gonna take all 12 bullets? Fuck you. I hate you so much. You're a dick. Yeah, I think this is what I use it on. Yes. Okay. That tells the sorter where to take that. For those wondering, what the hell are you doing with the barcode sticker? Telling it where to go. Now, the weapons room is over there, so I think the power room is actually right here. Yes. Let me in there. Now. No, this is not where I want to be. Not yet, anyway. Because I don't have the right tool. Shaped like an octagon. Poison gas in case of emergency, seal off. Okay. Pretty sure I don't want to be in here yet, but I guess I'm in here. Wait, maybe I do. Isn't this the power room here? Which, if I remember correctly, there'll be dogs in here to piss me off. Yes! This is where I want to be. Fuck you, Rover. Oh, the AK just tears them up. Goddamn iframes. Okay, taking too many bullets for a fucking dog. Seriously, how lame is that? 12% off of my gun to kill one dog. You know, those are 7.62 rounds. There's no way a fucking dog, even a mutated Doberman, could take that many shots from it. There's just no fucking way. Bullshit health the dogs have, just saying. Another one right there. Okay, I guess you can shoot them while they're down if you're aiming down at them. But that's beside the point. Let's grab these recovery items. There are two right here. Might as well put the last of my bullets in my handgun, too. Yeah, I've used them all up. I don't give a fuck. Gives me another item slot. Now, what we want to do, we got to turn on the power. Right. Somewhere back here is somewhere I can turn the power on. Oh, look, more bullets. Great, thanks. Look at all the fucking recovery items in this room, too. It's ridiculous. I wanted the bullets, Claire, but I'll take the green herb if you insist. Let's come out of caution. Where is the goddamn thing I'm supposed to interact with? It's kind of like hard to find. Oh, I guess I gotta turn the generator on first. But yeah, there's something else in here you can interact with. I'm forgetting what exactly. Couldn't remember if there was something against this wall or not. another green herb here by this dog's corpse. Right here. This turns on the power. Aww, look at the poor doggy. Just realize there are 5 green herbs in this room. 5! Alright. Power's on, which is good. Trying to get as much shit done down here as possible, because every time that I have to run past the moths is the time that I get aggravated. I just hate them so goddamn much. I'm missing a key item. Yeah, only the wheel. I think I gotta go upstairs to get the wheel, though. We'll go out, yeah. And, yeah, let's move the lever. Oh, well, why don't we turn the power on first, dumbass? There. Now we'll go back into the BOW room. If I have any space to pick this gas mask up. No, so I'll have to mix again. Because I want this gas mask. See, of course, you know, the BOW gas is harmless to people. Claire could stand in this all day. But the spider over there, it doesn't like that too much. It's probably, like, freaking out. Shitting itself, literally. Let's make sure there were no other doors down here that I hadn't gone into yet. Yeah, okay. I have to go past those goddamn moths again. I hate my life right now. I just do. Where's my AK? It's actually... If you look closely at this, it says it's an AK-47, right? It's actually an AK-74U with an extended magazine. If you look at it really closely, yeah, if it uses 7.62 rounds, then those dogs would get cut to pieces in like 2 to 3 shots. But then again, they justify it by giving you like fucking 7,000 bullets before the clip empties. Fuck you. Oh, fuck you. Okay, I'm fine. But you see how quickly it took him out? Oh, this one's still alive, son of a bitch. I said fuck you. I swear if I'm poisoned, I'm going to be angry. Okay, go up, Claire. We gotta clear the area. I have to go back to my box. Like, before I do anything else. And by the way, it is okay to use the AK. We're going to eventually give it to Chris. And he's going to find an extra clip for it. Oh, see, look at that bullshit. Automatically gets to hit you. It's like, fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fucking assholes. I have one of those things on my back now. Yep, so I mean, it's pointless for me to come in here because I'm probably going to get poisoned from it. The moths fucking suck. Horse cock. I hate them. Now I'm poisoned. Worst fucking enemy in the game. Not even kidding. Oh, they piss me the fuck right off. You can come all the way down here. I don't need you right now. So now what I have to do is go all the way across there and use the goddamn blue to cure my poison, or use the blue I'm carrying. Ugh, it's just a fucking huge pain in the ass. I hate it so much. You guys thought I hated the Bandersnatches? No. My rage for them is nothing in comparison. comparison to how goddamn fucking aggravating these moths are. They bring out the worst in me. They make me swear a lot. Okay. Let's go out here and deal with these constant respawning butt fuckers yet again. See, the shitty thing is, because of the angle, you can't see them half the time. But they go down in like 2 to 3 bullets, which is how it should be. And of course, I'm in caution, too. Yeah, eat a dick, fucking annoying moths. Hate you so much. And where they spawn is dependent on where you come in from, too, as we've seen. When I come in from this way, they appear right by the goddamn door, so that they're guaranteed to grab you if you try and run past them. Oh, I just hate them so goddamn much. Wait a minute, what am I missing? Where's the wheel, is my question. Why don't I have that yet? Oh, god damn it, I am pissed. I am fucking pissed. Do you know why I'm pissed? Because I have to go back behind by these stupid cocksuckers again, because now I have to go back and reveal Nosferatu. But to do so, I have to once again deal with these fuckers. God damn it, fuck you, suck my dick, you fucking asshole. See that? I killed it. There's a third one now all of a sudden. All of a sudden, there's a third one. But did you see that bullshit? I killed it, but it still managed to get its egg down. It's like, tss. I fucking hate them. Fuck you. Oh, imagine that. You're poisoned again. I don't care. I just don't. Fuck it. Let's go and push the switch. Hello, Nosferatu. Yeah, he looks happy. This poison's gonna kill me eventually. It does. It kills you pretty quick in this game, too, if I remember. Where's my key? That's what I'm after. Should have got that when I came down here to store. Yeah, we kind of need that, you dumb fuck. Let's come out of here and grab a double grain. Because I'm going to have to go kill these fuckers again. Again! Waste so much ammo on them, it's not even funny. Kill it, Claire. Thank you. What the fuck? How did you damage me? Okay. Whatever. Yeah, I'm orange caution. That's just from poison damage. Straight up poison. This door, this here looks like a door, but you can't actually go through it. I think it's just a panel of some sort. But yeah, I'm in orange caution just from poison. I figured I would be. That's why I grabbed a double green mix. But yeah, all the damage I took from the Bandersnatches and the dogs that I called bullshit earlier, that does just pales in comparison to those things. And I think I've spent enough time bitching about them, so let's move on. Now, where is this door? Oh, okay. I go through the double doors and take a left. The green, I think, tells me that. Need the AK right now. Combine! Yes, use a machine room key. There's a valve handle. Yeah, kind of an important key item that we very much need just to get away from this area and these stupid moths. I hate them so much. Should have a cutscene with Steve. Yep.
It looks like there's an Australian observation base about 7 miles away from here. That should be our target.
Then if we can break through the wall with that digging vehicle, we might have a chance.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Let's do it, Steve Burnside. Seriously, that's like his fucking saying. He said it like 4 or 5 times now. Steve decides that, oh, I'm just gonna look at her ass now instead of paying attention to what I'm doing.
Steve, watch out!
Dumbass.
No.
That's why we have the gas mask, by the way.
Come on!
Yeah, that gas is actually poisonous to us.
It's all my fault.
Yeah?
Don't say that. Listen to me. We'll escape from here. Together. Come on. We've got to shut off the gas. If we split up, we'll have a better chance of stopping it.
More like, get the fuck away from me so okay. You can't screw up anymore.
Steve! Don't forget. We'll get out of here. Together.
You know, can't blame Steve for being a guy. I totally get it, but you shouldn't be checking out a chick's ass while you're doing something that is, like, involving moving heavy machinery. You just shouldn't do it. Come on, I mean, like driving down a busy freeway and, like, you know, looking at porn on your phone. You just don't do it. It's a bad idea. Now, I should be able to change this. Fuck you, zombie. Because I did investigate the thing, I don't know. I think I can do this? Yep, I can. I don't have to go down there. Because I already investigated the hole. Where the valve panel fits. I am actually kind of surprising myself with how well I'm remembering this game, by the way. Yeah, the octa handle. We need it. Thank you. Hi! The zombie is getting more and more agitated every time I run past him. Now it's time for yet another shotgun shells in there. Time to yet again run past those things that put me in super rage mode. Zombies have respawned below me. That's no doubt done on purpose, just to be aggravated. Yep, key cutscene played, that's why. You know, with the Steve being an idiot. We are almost done with Claire, for the most part, too. Oh, I just don't want to do this. What do I have in my inventory, by the way? I need to grab the gas mask. I'm gonna put the AK away, too. Whatever, get out of my way. Hit me, I don't care. Didn't poison, so we're good. I'll get poisoned on my next pass. Oh, I am gonna prep for pretty much the end. I don't remember if I get to use an item box before or not, so I'm gonna do that now. Do I not? I don't need this blue herb. I'll put this away. Because when I get poisoned out here, which I will, I'll just jump back into the room and use it. I don't need the AK. I'm gonna give that to Chris. Give me a couple of mixes. Well, one should probably be sufficient. need some exploding arrows, 10 at least. Now, by doing the playing it the way I do, I'm not letting Chris use the bow gun. Which, you know, it's fine. He doesn't need it anyway. You know, he'll have his handgun, he'll have a shotgun, and he'll have the AK, and in a dish, and the grenade launcher, and SMGs he'll get a hold of later. So Chris doesn't really need the bow gun. I don't really need this extra ammo, though. I need the handgun bullets because I'm going to shoot these zombies out here. I'm trying to think of what all I need right now. Need the gas mask. Need two slots open for the rifle. I know there's a first aid spray out by the Nosferatu, but I don't really care about that. Try and kill these things before they get to me. Actually, you know what? Let's put the regular arrows in now. So I might use them. Wow, I actually killed them? Nope, there's still one left. Or is she looking at the body? I hope she's just looking at the body. Great, I just wasted bullets on my need. Way to go! Crash down, idiot! In here... Fuck. Why are there two of you right next to each other? You're just trying to be annoying. Oh, come on. Bullshit. That guy ate bullets. He's eating arrows, too, like nothing. What the fuck? Seriously. That guy took 100 arrows. And I shot him with several bullets prior. These zombies must have more health than normal. Probably to make you waste bullets, if you want to kill him. If you want to kill him. But all the arrows I put in him. He finally fucking went down. Yeah, I just used 50 arrows. Which room is it? Is it this room? I don't remember that exactly. It is this room. Yep, equip the gas mask and enter, which I don't think you can enter the room at all if you don't have the gas mask. There we go. La la la. La 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 la. Yeah, let's vent this shit.
We're safe now. Take your game, Claire.
Oh, hi, Al.
I shall enjoy watching you shriek in agony.
Not this time!
You again!
And Steve, again, does something useful. Yeah, to Steve's credit, he has done something useful a couple of times. Have a nice fall, Al. Uh-oh.
What was that?
That was Nosferatu. Get this stupid battle axe out of my way. Yeah, he looks mad. Just blows through his restraints like nothing. Like, fuck these restraints, we don't need them. Oh, look, a rifle. Yeah, I want that. They show it so that you don't fucking miss it, because if you miss it, it's really hard to kill Nosferatu. I mean, really hard. The bow gun will work, especially if you have plenty of exploding arrows. You can also kill him with your knife, too.
Claire! What are you doing? Let's go!
He's getting the rifle. Fuck you, Steve.
Are you ready? I'm gonna bust through that wall.
Go for it.
This is actually kind of cool. The water's flooding in. This is kind of funny. I can breathe with a sigh of relief now, too, guys, because we're done with the moths. They don't appear anymore in the game. Thank you.
Right.
Yes, let's get out in the sub-zero wind chill. They have got to be freezing
Claire,
right now.
Maybe we can escape through there.
Come on, let's go.
Yeah, we're only freezing to death out here. Since neither of us have winter jackets.
Claire, come on. Finally, we can get out of this insane place.
The point I have to make about this rifle is it's not accurate at all. Even if I have the shot lined up perfectly, it can miss. Maybe Alfred was really horseshit at sighting his weapons in. Because it will happen. That's why a lot of times I can't kill Nosferatu with the rifle, which is why I have these. So I could line up 7 perfect shots and it still wouldn't matter because sometimes it does not hit. I guess I'll take it. I don't give a shit. And whether or not he poisons you has something to do with Chris's game, but that's really not relevant, I guess, at this point. Let's start the boss fight. That's all it's up here is a handgun mag and a first aid spray.
Okay, let's go!
Come on, let's go! What are you
scared? This is another instance, too, whereas if he kills me, I restart right up here. Oh, look at that. He just grew some arms. That's nice. It's like, oh, my arms are tied. I need some more. I need an appendage here. He's just like, you know what? Fuck you, Steve. You just go down
Steve.
There. I'm just going to hang out for a little bit, Claire. You go ahead. He dropped his SMGs, too.
Hold on. I'll waste that monster and come back.
Claire.
I'll waste that monster.
Forget about
back.
Run!
She's, like, super confident in her abilities, which is kind of awesome, honestly. You don't want to be close to him. Because of his poison bullshit, now we gotta find him. Which, conveniently, the blizzard gets heavier and heavier for this boss fight. So it makes it really hard to see him. I don't know where he is right now, I'll be honest. Oh, there he is. Don't really want to spend too much time in corners either, because his arm can knock you off the edge. Like that. I'm dead. See that shit? Insta-gib. Awesome. First death! Ha ha ha! Fuck you, Nosferatu. You suck, dick. Alright, let's go ahead and do this. Oh, right. I suppose I gotta re-pick up this shit. Not even gonna load my handgun, I don't care. What's really nice is, where the hell are the bullets? I do want those. Don't really give a shit about the spray, I just want the freaking bullets. Skipping cutscenes with the select button is nice, especially
okay,
when you run into bullshit deaths like that. Alright. Now I'm trying to get a shot off while he's spitting his poison bullshit. I don't even care that he's hitting me. I'd rather you hit me than knock me off the edge, because that was aggravating as hell. That was a good shot. The shit combos you too, so you gotta be careful. It's hard to really know how badly your health is. I gotta move towards the middle more. Turn around, asshole. Got him. One bullet left. Got him. How many bullets are left in this thing? One? Okay. Let's do a heal, because I don't know how bad low my health is. Fuck. Now we have to go to these. Yeah, I can never kill him with the rifle. Never, ever. But that gets him every time. 10 of those, he's done. No, he's just kind of hanging out.
Claire! You're alive!
Well, duh. Weren't you listening to the fight? He's just kind of hanging.
I'm sorry. I failed you.
Don't worry about it. Let's go.
Yeah, don't let it happen again, damn it. It's like, wow, she killed the monster. Holy shit.
I swear I'll protect you next time, Claire.
Yeah, okay, Steve. Although, to be fair, he's been doing a pretty decent job of it. He's been keeping Al from killing her.
We did it! We're finally out!
Look, and we're freezing to death!
There's a snowmobile over there!
Yeah! I don't know, maybe they're immune to the weather.
Perfect!
We're
we'll
done
to
with Claire
right
now.
Over to the Australian
quite a
base
too,
with this.
Yeah, let's go!
This cutscene rocks. I'm just gonna sit here and drink my beer and watch this one, I think.
Don't forget about this, Claire.
Meanwhile, back at the ranch.
Following up on a lead given to me by Leon has brought me here.
A prisoner who lost everything. Shit, there goes... was most of his gear. That's okay, we didn't need it anyway. We'll find what we need, Chris. Still has his gun. That's really what matters.
Don't worry, Claire. I'm coming to save you.
Right on. Ah, the worm's getting hungry. Of course, we're back on the island. I think we're by the prison in a different area that was inaccessible as Claire. Chris has a different handgun, too. His is actually better. Yeah, he has a Glock 17. It was better than Claire's M93R. Well, here's Rodrigo.
I didn't expect to find another living person left on this island. Who are you?
I came here looking for a certain girl.
A girl?
Have you seen anyone named Claire Redfield?
Did you just say Claire?
You know
who he stuttered.
She is, don't you?
Don't worry about her. I helped her escape. Several planes took off from this island not long ago. While I can't say for certain, she was probably on one of them.
I see. I guess my sister owes you. Thanks for helping.
Everyone's gone. I may be the only other person left. Go on. Follow your sister and get off this island.
Okay, have it your way, dude. Big fucking worm. I guess Rodrigo is dinner. You know, interesting thing is you're actually on a timer to kill the worm. You know, Chris is like, oh, I gotta save him. If you don't kill the worm in a set amount of time, Rodrigo dies. And Chris doesn't get something that he really needs. But look at what I have access to. All of Claire's weapons, except the bowgun, which she still has, but we don't need that anyway. We have the AK. The worm can be killed with the handgun. Actually, I might take the AK, too, just because. And I could take a mix. I'll figure that out when I get back.